We're supposed to be on, aren't we?
Getting close. Hello, anybody there? Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. I hope they let them know.
They probably didn't. About the time change. Maybe we'll just do it for obubison.com today.
Are we connected? Hello? Hello, 1, 2, 3. matchup between the Tigers of East Central and the Bison of OBU. We'll step aside for this opening timeout. Be back with our pregame comments and comments from Bo Overton. It's all coming up next. This is OBU Basketball and Classic Hits, KGFF. Thank you, sir. Yes, Scott Bob has been here. I went and did an interview with Bo. I said, you need to stay here just in case they come on, needing to talk to somebody. He was talking, nothing. Oh. Todd Miller, Scott Wunsch, Bob Easley, our crew on this Saturday evening here at the Noble Complex. It's East Central 4-3, 1-2 in GAC play. Visits 2-1 Oklahoma Baptist to the league, and the Bison are off to a 6-3 start after a very impressive 66-51 victory last time out a week ago today here against Southeastern. Scott, of that ball game, really everything focused around the Bison defense. They held Southeastern to 18 made field goals that tied for an opponent season low. The other was Northeastern State. They also held Southeastern, a cold shooting Savage Storm team, to just 4 made three-pointers. That two was a season low. Actually, the second fewest by an opponent, Northwestern, made 3 about 3 weeks ago up at Alba. But defensively, this team played extremely well. They're allowing 63 points per game, both overall and their first three conference starts.
Well, big key to Oklahoma Baptist on their defense is on the defensive rebounding end, they're getting 73% of the loose balls. Whether they hit the floor or not or pick them up, they're only allowing the teams basically one shot at that. And when you don't have those repeat offensive rebounds, it's easier to hold down the other team.
Bison are being out-rebounded on the offensive glass by 12 overall, 94-82. That rebound percentage you're talking about of 73% is second only to Northwestern Oklahoma State in the Great American Conference through the first three games for everybody in league play. The Bison averaging 69 a game. They're outscoring their first nine opponents, and they played a good non-league schedule by 6 per game. East Central is outscoring their first 7 opponents by nearly 10 points per ball game, and allowing 61.4. However, in conference play, it's a little bit different as they've given up almost 68 per game, but this is still a typical Matt Cole team. They're going to have shooters. They're going to have scorers all over the floor, and you bring up rebounding. We're going to hear it from Bo in just a moment in his pregame comments. Rebounding is essential to beat East Central. OBU finally beat the Lady Tigers in back-to-back games a year ago, the first of which was here at Shawnee on February the 11th, and that snapped a 10-game losing streak in a series, but it's been the same thing every year. They either make shots or they don't beat you initially, but they get the 50-50 balls and put it back in for baskets.
Yeah, that's why that defensive rebounding stat is so important for the Bison. Andrea Petrarita, Khalifa Ford, others. You know, Jalen Stapleton is really one of the top Bison rebounders, only being 5'5", because he has a nose for the basketball. She'll drop down from the top part of the you know, around the top of the key and get a lot of those longer rebounds to help the post players.
All right, we'll take our second pregame timeout. When we return, we'll hear from Bison women's basketball coach Bo Overton before his team hosts East Central tonight here at the Noble Complex. This is Oklahoma Baptist Bison basketball on KGFF. Thank you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Maybe Arena at the Noble Complex for OU Bison basketball. Today's matchup features the East Central University Tigers and your Oklahoma Baptist University Bison.
Saturday evening for the Noble Complex. Todd Miller now joined by head coach Bo Overton as the women's basketball team plays their final home game of 2021, taking on East Central. Coach, a good win last week. The last time we saw you against Southeastern, a game that you guys defended maybe as well as you've defended in the 2 years that you've been here.
Well, it was, and you know, they're a very good team, skilled, they all can shoot it. And I think when you play a team like that, you really have to, you know, be good at all phases. And I thought we rebounded well. I thought we took care of the ball, which kind of kept them from getting out and getting easy looks. So when you play a team like that, you better be well-rounded, and I thought we were.
Before the game last week, you told Khalifa, you said, we're really going to have you in this matchup. But I thought she responded very, very well for you.
Well, I think, you know, just the matchup of who we're playing, because the game before that, you know, the team played a lot of zone, so we were having to make some shots. And then against Southeastern, you know, now they're going to guard you one-on-one, and that's her strength. So we got to get the ball to her, and she's got to attack, and I thought she did that very good.
First step for you when you took this program over was just teaching these girls how to win again. Okay, they now know how to win again. Now they're finding ways to win in different types of scenarios, aren't they?
Well, I'd love to take credit for teaching someone how to win, but I think what happens is if you make some shots, then you win, and they've been doing that. Just all phases, you know, we've defended, we've rebounded, been shooting the ball well, and a lot of that goes to just the execution of the players. You know, they're figuring out where the ball's supposed to be at certain times of the game, and executing very well, and then continuing to just play very, very hard. And if we do that, play hard, rebound the ball, I think we'll make shots and we'll be okay.
Does your weekly practice schedule focus a lot on defense? Because that seems to be the area where this program has improved or made its biggest jump in 2 years.
I don't think we've really changed anything we've done as far as the itinerary of what we're doing during the day. I think a lot of it is just the experience of the players, you know, getting more reps. When you get more reps, You know, one of the things I'm anxious to look at is I think our depth's getting better.
Yeah.
You know, I think we can play 8, 9, 10 people and play very well with them. And a lot of that has to do with the freshmen and the young players and the new players getting more reps. And when you're 8, 9, 10 games in now, you know, we're already at a third of the season. So we're getting to that point where we are getting a lot of reps, and it's showing on the floor.
One of the areas that I think that depth has really been beneficial in is at the point guard position. Last year you had to ride Jalen so hard because you had to have her out there almost entirely for a ball game. Kendall Parker has really come in and accepted that backup role and done a very nice job for you.
Kendall's done very well. I think the fact, like we talked about with reps, can't be more important for that with her. Because she just needs to play, needs to see the speed of the game, needs to know the execution of what we're doing by doing more reps. And then I think the fact that, you know, we have Peyton Taylor, who's a senior, you know, we can always play her at that spot, and we do some, gives us a really good point guard position with a lot of depth.
I guess if you could answer this question, she wouldn't be doing what she's doing. But what's going on with Malou Savannah? I mean, she just has never really gotten into a rhythm offensively.
Well, I think the fact that I think I saw the stats where, you know, how she was shooting from three, and that doesn't bother me as long as she's doing everything else. And she does. She works extremely hard in practice. I think when she comes in the game, she knows how to play and makes the right plays, the right passes, is where she's supposed to be on the defensive end. I really believe that she's a player that when she gets some more shots up, she'll start making shots, and I'd love to see that happen tonight. You know, I think last time we played them, I think she had made 4 threes in the first half. So I told her about that yesterday, and I'm looking forward to, you know, her getting going today.
East Central is a team you're going to need to have all hands on deck. I mean, this is a quality program and one that up until the end of last year seemingly had OBU's number every time out.
Well, they're just all so skilled. They're skilled, they're quick, and they all can. When you put 5 players on the floor that all the time can shoot it and score, that's a different scenario than you're used to. You know, usually you just got to guard 1 or 2 players. Well, with them, you got to guard 5 out there. And so we'll have to adjust some things and move some things around and have some matchups, hopefully, that'll favor us. And I think the biggest thing will just be, you know, rebounding the ball, just not giving them second chances. Talked to the team about they're really good in transition offense, so we got to get back and get matched up quickly. And if we do those things, then we should be okay.
You look at the roster, it's most of the similar names and faces that we've seen in the past, with one exception. They have a junior college transfer that you said really has made them even a much more dangerous club.
Well, if you just look at her numbers, I mean, you know, she was shooting almost 60% from three until she missed a couple against Southwestern. So she's still, you know, north of 50%. So, and that's their, you know, that's who our 5 player will be guarding. You know, you're talking about Andrea and Jill and Sierra. So we got to stay close to her and make sure we know where she is at all times. And what will happen is that, you know, then she'll open up the other players. So we just have to play a solid game against everybody.
I know it's been dead week. It's been finals week around here, so it hasn't been totally rest time. But going into the final stretch of 2021, do you like the fact that you've had more just us time and not a schedule loaded with a bunch of games?
No question. You know, I talked about we need those reps, and we're getting them. I think the other thing is, you know, I think we're getting healthy. You know, Jalen's been battling that ankle. Mal's been battling a muscle pull, and we're getting Sierra back tonight. Hopefully I can get her in the game tonight and play this game today, have another 5 or 6 days off to get healthy, and then come back, and then here we go.
Important in this league to defend home territory, and you guys have been really good. All double-digit wins to this point here at the Noble.
Always have to defend your home court. They know that, and it all comes down to just, you know, we got to execute, you know, play that possession by possession, that quarter by quarter, you know, that 5-minute timeout to the next 5-minute timeout, and if we do that, we'll be okay.
Bo Overton in his second season here on Bison Hill, 10-20. He's 5-16 against the league. Two of those five victories, though, came last year in the truncated COVID-19 season of 2021. He beat East Central the final two meetings to snap a 10-game in-series losing skid for OBU against the Tigers. We were also talking about the junior college transfer. Kate Ogle is her name. She's a 5'11 junior from Baldwin City, Kansas. She's one of two Tigers that average double figures. Ogle averages 12 points, 2.7 rebounds per ballgame, and has made 18 three-point baskets. Those 18 three-point baskets are the most on the ECU squad through seven games. East Central is in the middle of a four-game road trip. It started in Weatherford. It will conclude on New Year's Day in Russellville, Arkansas, against Arkansas Tech. The Lady Tigers were preseason picked 7th in the conference coaches poll. And again, they are led by one Madison Reel. She's an outstanding player. 5'6 super senior from Edmond Deer Creek High School, averaging 14 points and 3.3 rebounds. Madison Reel against Arkansas Fort Smith back on the 20th of November became the 14th member of ECU's 1,000-point scoring club. She did so on a free throw. She enters tonight's game with 1,071 points, and when she eclipsed the 1,000-point barrier, she was the first Lady Tiger to eclipse that mark in 6 years. Madison Reel also ranks in the top 10 in East Central program history in starts, in double-figure games, in assists, minutes played, free throws attempted, and free throws made. She is a very, very good player, and we certainly have seen enough of her to know that and see what she is capable of doing on a nightly basis. Today will be her 109th game played at East Central. That is the ninth most in program history. She also begins play today with a 793 free throw percentage average. That is 10th all-time in program history. More pregame notes as East Central and Oklahoma Baptist loom at the top of the hour. It's the Lady Tigers and the Bison tonight right here on Classic Hits KGFF. Thank you. Yeah. Today's game is presented by McIntyre Law. When experience matters, OBU alumnus Noble McIntyre and his award-winning team of personal injury attorneys are ready to help. Visit them online at McIntyreLaw.com. A trip around the Great American Conference scoreboard. Of course, most of the games were contested this afternoon. Two are finals. One was postponed. Another was played on Tuesday night. Here are the finals. Northwestern beats Southeastern in Alva today behind 22 points from Bailey Brown. 71-68 Lady Rangers. That's their first conference victory of the year. Tuesday night, Southwestern defeated Southern Nazarene. That game was in Weatherford, 72-60. And earlier today, over in Arkansas, Ouachita kept Arkansas Monticello winless on the season, 87-59. The Lady Tigers roll over the Cotton Blossoms. About to tip this afternoon, Henderson State at Harding. That game will go 30 minutes after we tip here at 5 o'clock inside the Noble Complex. We talked about Khalifa Ford of the pregame show, really responding to the challenge her coach put forward on Saturday afternoon of a week ago. She had 24 points against Southeastern. That was one shy of a career high of 25 that she set against Northwestern Oklahoma State. That was in 2021, but it was in the spring season of last year. We also said that OBU has been very good at home this year. In fact, they are 3-0 with 14, 21, and 15-point wins. Those over Northeastern State, Midwestern State, and most recently a 66-51 victory over Southeastern. East Central enters the game 2-2 away from Ada. They have road wins at Texas Woman's and St. Mary's. They've lost on the road at Southwestern and at Southern Nazarene. That is our pregame show tonight from Shawnee. Stay tuned. The starting lineups and the opening tip is coming up next. This is Bison Basketball on Classic Hits, KGFF.
Dear Lord, we thank you for this day. We thank you for everything that you give to us. Thank you for
thank you.
Us, for creating us. We pray for all those that are hurting or sick. We pray for healing for them. We pray for safety for track. We also pray for the safety of these players as they play. Let them play to the best of their ability. In your name we pray. Amen.
Shawnee, tip-off moments away, Central and Oklahoma Baptist, game one of this pushed-back start time due to winter commencement here on Bison Hill at Raleigh Chapel. The starters for the Lady Tigers, Madison Real, the newest 1,000-point scorer at ECU. She is a redshirt senior out of Deer Creek High School in Edmond. Izzy Cummings will start, a 5'8 redshirt sophomore from Elgin. Kate Ogle, we discussed her in the pregame show, their second double-figure score of the year, averaging 12 per ball game. She is a junior college transfer, 5'11 out of Baldwin City, Kansas. Mackenzie Crusoe will start, a 5'7 redshirt freshman from Choctaw. Tonight will be her 27th consecutive start. She averages 9 points, 6 rebounds a game. And their fifth starter is Alexis Lyons, a 5'10 senior from Macy, Nebraska. She has a career high of 3 blocks against OBU on two different occasions. Lyons averages 8 points and 4 rebounds a game. Matt Cole is the head Tiger at Ada. In his eighth season, the former Northeastern State assistant coach is 95-98. They went 10-9 last year. Matt Cole is only the fourth women's head basketball coach at East Central, dating back to 1990. 56. To get his starters, Madison Real, Izzy Cummings, Kate Ogle, Mackenzie Crusoe, and Alexis Lyons. Here's the starters tonight for OBU. No change in Bo Overton's lineup. It's Mallory Lockhart, the transfer from OCU, a 5'7 junior from Keller, Texas, averaging 13.8 a game, and is one away from tying for the national lead in three-pointers made. She's made 33 this season. Jalen Stapleton is the straw that stirs the drink for OBU. Third-year letter winner here at OBU, a 5'5 senior from Meade, Kansas, averaging 8.3 points per ball game and 3.9 rebounds. Peyton Taylor will start, a 6-foot senior from Ada and a transfer from OCU. 3.4 points and 2.6 rebounds per ball game. Andrea Petrarida will get the start inside. She's a 6'1 senior from Vilnius, Lithuania, averaging 10 points, 5.3 rebounds, and shooting 55% of the ball game. Andrea Petrarida missed the first two games of the year, losses to Pittsburgh State and Washburn. And Khalifa Ford, OBU's leading scorer at 14.8 a game and leading rebounder at 8.4, completes the starting lineup, a 5'10 junior from Bono, Arkansas. Yet she was 1 point shy of matching a career high set earlier this calendar year against Northwestern in last year's truncated season. So again, it's Lockhart, Stapleton, Taylor, Petrarida, and Khalifa Ford for Bo Overton, who is 2-2 against his hometown school in Central. Bo, of course, graduated from Ada High School.
Yeah, big wins last year. You know, East Central knocked off some people last year being hot and then kind of tailed off at the end of the season. And it looks like this Kate Ogle is going to pick up the gap here in the inside with these offensive rebounds. It's important that Petrarida and Ford keep her off the boards.
Ogle jumps in her against Andrea Petrarida, and we're underway as OBU wins the opening tip. Bison will move from left to right across your radio dial here in the first half of play in the home green, white, or white, green, and gold. Lockhart against the man-to-man defense, pressured left wing side by Madison Real. Now to Petrarida. She swings it right for Stapleton, curls around a screen, draws a double, and leaves it to the foul line. Petrarida let fly a jump shot. She back rims it, and East Central in the road. Black and Orange has the rebound.
And Ogle did a great job to keep Khalifa Ford off the boards. A perfect block out.
Madison Real attacks. Stapleton slides down, cuts her off baseline. They cross court it. Now go wing right for Alexis Lyons. She'll step inside the arc. Her long two barely hits the front of the rim. Stapleton with a rebound, but it's poked away from behind by Ogle. It's picked up by Cummings. Up ahead to Ogle, and she blew the layup. Jalen with a rebound. Up ahead to Lowry. East Central gets back, and a kick ball violation against Madison Real. No scores. We played 54 seconds here in the opening period.
That was really a good rebound by Jalen Stapleton, dropping down from the top side of the defense. Coach Overton didn't like it, getting that ball punched out. She knows better that she's got to protect that ball going up the court.
Peyton Taylor will inbound to Stapleton, and to Ford, who's double to the high post. Back to Jalen, swings it right to Peyton. Taylor over the top, gets it to Petrarida, who slipped, and they're going to call a foul against East Central. They called it Alexis Lyons, and I swear, Scott, she slipped or got her feet tangled up underneath her.
Yeah, I would say that's a get-out-of-jail-free card right there.
First foul of the contest against East Central. Lockhart will handle the inbounds pass, bounces it to Stapleton right slot. East Central in a man-to-man. Peyton Taylor on a cross-court pass, drives, is cut off left low post. Now pivots, goes out front. Ford's three on the way is good. Khalifa gives OBU the first lead of the contest in her fifth three-pointer. Ford is shooting 50% with that make one dog from beyond the arc.
And she started last time the win against Southeastern with a three-pointer at the top of the key. That's just going to open it up big time for her in the lane.
Last two games, OBU is 8 for 19 to this building from three-point range. 3-0 to OBU. Wing left is Crusoe. They run her off the arc. She throws up a left-handed layup, missed it, and an over-the-back violation against Izzy Cummings. OBU emphasizing rebounding, Scott. We talked about in the pregame show, and so far, Bo Overton's defense has limited East Central to just one shot now.
Yep, great defensive triangular rebounding inside the offensive shooters, and that was a clear foul. Izzy Cummings really ran over Lockhart hard there.
Jalen with it, foul on extended right wing to Mallory, top of the circle. East Central looks like they're still in that man-to-man defense. Ford thought about a three, dumps it down low. Petrarida squares up and scores. And it's a 5-0 start for OBU. 70 seconds into the first period.
Great job by Petrarida below the dotted line. Had Alexis Lyons pushed back toward the goal. Easy score inside.
Crusoe left wing to Cummings. OBU in a zone defense and a offensive. No, they're going to say that Ogle stepped to the sideline right in front of the OBU bench. 5-0 the OBU lead. 7:37 to play here in the opening period for the Noble Complex, where OBU averages in three victories, better than 12 points per game over the opposition. Taylor is cut off, tried to get around a screen, couldn't. Now goes to Stapleton, who jump passes in the paint. Ill-advised pass in traffic, and it's taken away by Cummings. DeReal through two defenders, left-handed layup is good. And with 7:22 to play in the first period, East Central is on the board.
Yeah, more often than not, when Stapleton gets in the lane, good things happen. But against three taller players, just block and stole the ball.
5-2 OBU. Petrarita squares up and banks it into the rim. Jump shot on the left block. Andreas shooting doubles 55% as 4-7 OBU back in front by five.
I think Matt Cole's going to have to put Ogle on Petrarita, because Petrarita is just abusing Lyons down low.
Lyons to Rio, who fumbles, drives it underneath the bucket, cross courts it to Cummings for three, and she got it. Well, that's a big bucket for Izzy Cummings, and it's down to a 2-point game at 7-5.
Yeah, and Izzy Cummings last year didn't really pull the trigger all that much with the other 3-point shooters, so that is big for the Tigers.
She hasn't this year either, just her 14th attempt, and she's shooting 50%. Ford pivots away from a double team and drains a foul line left jumper.
Great job by Ford using that pivot foot, the left side, ducking inside just outside the left elbow, then duck under for the little jumper.
OBU sizzling off to a 4-for-5 start. They've limited East Central to just 2-of-5. Lyons with the top of the circle to Caruso, and she traveled. That's going to be turnover number 2 for East Central, and we get a timeout. 6:08 to play. It's charged to East Central. Oklahoma Baptist leads early 9-5 over the Lady Tigers on Classic Hits KGFF.
Attorney Jordan Klinger at McIntyre Law. We have over 100 years of experience fighting for Oklahomans injured in automobile and semi-accidents. Distracted driving is an epidemic. According to government studies, 1 in 4 crashes now involve texting and driving. That's 1.6 million accidents caused each year by distracted drivers. If you have been injured and you want to know your rights, call us now. The consultation is free. We love what we do, and we're good at it. We are trial lawyers. Call McIntyre Law today.
Free water.
Right here, Madison.
Rebounding early, OBU with a 3-1 advantage. Neither team with an offensive rebound. The Bison have hit 4 of their first 5. ECU just 2-of-5. Both teams are 1-of-1 from 3-point range. 9-5 OBU out of the East Central timeout. Bison set the table in the front court with Jalen Stapleton. Now to Petrarita, top of the circle. Right side to Taylor, dumps it down low to Ford, loses it, gathers it, kicks it cross court to Stapleton, who air balls a three. Khalifa with a rebound, is trapped to the baseline, gets it out to Lockhart. Her three front rims. Khalifa runs to the rebound again, and is tied up. And now they're going to call Ford for a foul. That's the first against OBU, and it comes with 5:48 to play here in the first period, with the homestanding Bison leading by 4.
Well, Oklahoma Baptist got extra shots there. Wide open three from the left wing by Stapleton. Ford got an extra shot, and then Petrarita got a little too much under the rim where she didn't get the offensive rebound.
Russo bounces it slot right for Lyons, who cross courts it for McKenzie. Back across the floor, right wing, it's Izzy Cummings. In the corner, it's Lyons, who steps into a three. It rattles off, no good. Ford thought about the rebound, peeled away as her teammate Stapleton controls. Jalen up the left sideline, dances on the wing, dumps it down low to Andrea. Petrarita goes left to right, throws it up, it rolls across the rim, and falls off into the arms of Kate Ogle.
Nice move by Petrarita, no finish.
Driving baseline real. They blanket her. They pull it back out, working around the perimeter. Ogle run off the three-point arc. Had it knocked away as she tried to deliver a pass down low. That's the second East Central turnover. Lockhart with it to Stapleton. Jalen spins it on the front court to Mallory. Now to Khalifa through the circles. Right wing, it's Taylor. Underneath the Petrarita goes up with contact. Missed it. Andrea gets it back. More contact. There was no whistle. And East Central finally has the rebound.
Well, Petrarita's not finding the right spot on the square down low.
Quick three put up wing left by Izzy Cummings. It rolls off for the rebound. 4:41 to play, opening period, 9-5 OBU. Stapleton drives baseline left, bounces it for Petra Ryan on the right block. She muscles up and missed it. Boy, Lyons is being really physical right now with Andrea.
Yeah, she is, but if Andrea just goes into her a little bit, she's going to score.
How about Lowry Lockhart blocking the shot that time of Madison Real? She went to the floor. East Central wanted a travel, no whistle. Khalifa Ford attacks right down the paint, throws up a runner and banks it in. Khalifa already with 7. Boy, she is focused again today in the lead of 6.
Yeah, Mackenzie Caruso was on Ford that time. Ford just took her off the dribble at the right side of the lane, forced it off the glass.
Bad news for the rest of the league. Khalifa Ford is healthy. Wing right, it's Izzy Cummings. Top of the circle to Caruso. Pump fakes, drives. Taylor cuts it off, and Caruso hits a fallaway jumper in the paint. Mackenzie Caruso, who averages just under 10 a game, with her first bucket.
You know, Peyton Taylor was step for step with Caruso, but she fell off of her when she pulled up at the dotted line.
Lead cut down to 4. Taylor left of a Ford screen, draws contact going down the paint, and a blocking foul. And that's going to go against Alexis Lyons, and that will be her 2nd. Lyons, honestly, was very fortunate, Juan Dog, 2 possessions ago. She didn't pick up her 2nd as she was banging around with Petra Rieta.
And I think she would have got her 2nd foul if Petra Rieta would have been more aggressive going to the glass. Todd, instead of shooting those fall-away jump shots, you shoot those fall-away jumpers, you're not going to get to the free throw line.
Jill Leslie comes into the ball game. Also checking in for OBU will be Kennedy Large. At the free throw line is Peyton Taylor. The Ada native switches down to 1st. Taylor had 3 points against Southeastern. Her season in OBU career high is 8 against Midwestern State. Ford and Petra Rieta out of the ball game, and Taylor rattles both home. She'll check out as Madison Chambers, the 5'11 junior from Muldrow, averaging 3 points and 2.2 rebounds, mostly in a reserve role with 3 starts, checks in.
Yeah, Bo Overton doing a good job getting rest for a lot of his players at certain times.
Ogle drives it underneath the basket, cross courts it. They pull it back out front. Madison Real with a left-handed dribble gets into the paint, throws up a runner and banks it home. Madison with 4, and it's 13-9 OBU.
And OBU knows that Madison Real is left-handed. She's on the right wing. Just make her go right. She gets right up the middle of the lane with the left hand, strong off the board.
Good ball movement by OBU. Flashing high as Leslie dumps it down low. The ball underthrown, looking for Chambers in the low post. It's tipped away. That's actually Kennedy Large. OBU with their 2nd turnover here early. Right side is Kate Ogle against the matchup zone defense. They drive baseline left. Cummings cut off by Chambers to the cutter, and the left-handed layup is good. That's Caruso. So Caruso with 4 straight, and that's the run for East Central. The Lady Tigers are within 2, the closest they've been since 2-0.
Yeah, Kate Ogle set that up on the previous defensive stop by intercepting that pass.
Driving baseline and an offensive foul, and that is against Jalen Stapleton. And our head coach, Bo Overton, in front of us is not happy, and he's thinking the exact same thing about CDU. You've got teammates wide open.
That's right, and she dribbled again into 3 defenders. And I think that's a good call. At least one of them had to be set down there.
Out she comes. Kendall Parker comes in, the ever-improving 5'6 freshman from Plano, Texas, averaging almost 6 points a game in her first collegiate season here at Shawnee. East Central could take the lead with a 3 of this possession. They've never led. Down low with it is Allison, who spins left to right against Jill Leslie, who forced her into a tough shot. She misses everything. Into the front court with it is Lockhart. Down low to Large. Goes up. It's blocked. They're going to call a jump ball, and the arrow belongs to East Central.
That was another great defensive play. Madison Chambers maybe not the biggest post down there, trying to shoot over the trees. Got it caught up.
Give a pump fake there, and you're probably at the foul line. 2:06 to play, first period. 11-11. Madison Real. They set a back cross quarter for Ogle. Up her 1st 3. It's short. Large with a rebound. Leads the break. It's 3-on-3. Down to Madison. Chambers right wing to Parker. Out top to Leslie, and she airballs the 3. Not certain that's the shot that Bo Overton was looking for.
Well, she was wide open, and not only was Jill Leslie wide open, but she shot that outside the men's 3-point line, so she could have moved in about 5 feet.
Lockhart comes out, Malou Savannah comes in, so right now OBU does not have a starter on the floor leading by 2. Leslie, incidentally, now 1-for-5 from 3-point range. Kennedy Cummings has checked in for the Lady Tigers to Caruso. She crosses over, gets deep against Madison Chambers, who commits the foul. And that's the 1st on Madison, the 3rd against OBU, amongst 3 different players. Big game today of the Great American Conference men's side. Front-running Southeastern playing in Alva against Northwestern. The Rangers, 1 of 8 teams, one of which includes OBU, a 2-1 of the league. fell at home to Southeastern 72-58. First foul shot is good by Crusoe, and she'll get a second. This would tie the game.
Yeah, last week Overton was in this position. He had Khalifa Ford on all that time, but Khalifa didn't have any fouls last week. She's got one right now.
Crusoe was six straight. That's the run for East Central, and the game is tied at 13 with a minute and a half to play in the opening period. Savannah with it right side. Gets it to Kendall Parker. Down low for Large. A little shimmy shake. Lays it in, and a buck. They're going to call an offensive foul.
I don't know about that. That looked like a kind of an Academy Award flop there.
I thought she did a good job of that little shimmy shake shoulder fake. Instead, OBU turns it over for the third time. Bison and East Central tied at 13. Wing right, Kennedy Cummings. Two dribbles, goes top of the circle. Ogle swings it left baseline. Shot clock is halfway down. Game clock at a minute six to play in the period. Driving left as Allison misses a scoop shot. Large with a rebound to Parker. Under a minute now to go with the opening period. First of two this year between the Tigers and the Bison. Wing left to Savannah, to Chambers, through the top of the circle. Now to Parker, drives baseline, lays it up with a foul. And Kennedy Cummings just could not stay with the quickness that time of Kendall Parker.
Well, you called it earlier, Todd, just use a ball fake. Kendall Parker faked the pass to the lane and then darted toward the rim and then got the foul.
OBU out-rebounded East Central early, 11-6. Large first foul shot, no good. She's a 72% free throw shooter. The Bison are 74% as a team, and they were really good here a week ago against Southeastern, converting 11 of 12 charity tosses. Second one crawls off, no good, so the game remains tied at 13. 46 seconds to go in the period. Crusoe cuts right. On the wing with the basketball now is Gabby Cummings. They'll swing it back out front, left side to Caruso, through the top of the key. Leaves it for Gabby Cummings, right side for Kennedy Cummings. 30 seconds to play in the first period, and Malou Savannah commits a foul at the top of the circle. That's her first.
You know, you got to give another Academy Award to Kennedy Cummings. It was light contact. Her head and red hair just flopping all over the place, thinking like it was some kind of collision.
First foul against Ballou. Foul shot, pitballs in and out for Kennedy Cummings. She'll have one more. East Central still looking for their first lead of the contest. And that one is up, and it's good. So Cummings off the bench gives East Central a 14-13 lead, a difference of less than a full second on the shot and game clock late first period. Savannah with it right side, gets a little bit of a pick, drives to the baseline, bounces it for Parker. Back to Ballou, right corner three is short off the front of the rim. East Central with it off the floor, it's Kate Ogle. Now the Lady Tigers can play for the final shot of the opening period. Under 10 seconds to go, 14-13 ECU. They get a screen, they'll fire a three. Chambers blocks the shot attempt out front. Ball on the floor and a travel call as it's picked up wing right by Kennedy Allison. And how about the defense by Madison Chambers blocking a three?
Yeah, with the left hand. Didn't go for the fake. Was like a quick release three. She jumped with the left hand and knocked that ball away.
OBU inbounds, and that sounds the end of the first period. 14-13, Lady Tigers at the end of one. Back after these messages on Classic Hits, KGFF.
Visit Lowe's today, your one-stop shop for DIY projects and all home improvement needs. Located at 4817 North Kickapoo in Shawnee.
Okay.
The month of January is all about
Noble McIntyre, McIntyre Law. We have over 100 years of combined litigation experience fighting for Oklahomans injured by medical malpractice and medical devices. These injuries are caused by medical products including defective hip implants, hernia mesh and breast implants, and IVC filters, as well as drugs such as Valsartan, Xarelto, and Celgence. If you have been injured and want to learn more about your rights, call us right now. The consultation is free. We love what we do, and we're good at it. We are trial lawyers. Call McIntyre Law today.
Bison started the game well, hitting four of their first five. They missed eight of their last nine and shoot 35% of the first period. East Central started cold. They're still cold, 5 for 15, but they have their first lead as we start the second period. It's 14-13. Bison basketball, large to Savannah, who spins left baseline. Back to Parker. Her three rolls off. Down underneath, Allison with a rebound for East Central. In transition, it's Madison Real up ahead to Kennedy Cummings. Cummings drives, slips, lost the handle, and Jill Leslie picks it up. That's turnover number 4 for East Central. Parker with a head on a swivel brings it to the front court. Now to Chambers, top of the circle. Madison with her 5th block to end the first period for OBU. Wing left with it is Savannah. Malou dumps it down low to Leslie as it poked away. Jill gets it back. Now to Parker. Right side of Chambers. Leslie flashes high. Now to Kennedy. Parker around the screen behind the back. Backs it out of the foul line. With 4 to shoot, comes up short of the jump shot. Real with a rebound. Goes through 2 defenders all the way to the goal and lays it in, and it's a 3-point lead for ECU.
And Madison Real will do that on anybody with the left hand. The right hand, she will not. All you have to do is just make her go to the right side. She's not that fast.
8:56 to play before halftime, 16-13 East Central. Wing left with it is Malou Savannah, guarded by her opposite number 3, Madison Real, and she pushed off. Malou has turned it over on her second personal foul, and that's team foul number 1, with 70 seconds gone here in the second period against OBU.
Yeah, the trail official was standing right there next to Savannah. She raised that right arm. When she extended, it's going to be called.
8:41 to play, first half. Todd Miller, Scott Wanish, Bob Easley with you here courtside of the Noble Complex. Cummings with it left side. Kennedy gives it up top of the circle to Madison Real. Real wants some motion, now feeds it right side to Izzy Cummings. He jump passes in the paint, and it's out of bounds. 2 straight empty possessions for ECU as OBU gets it back down just 3.
I thought Kennedy Large jumped up with both hands and tipped that ball away.
Bison still going with all reserves out there on the floor. 90 seconds gone here into the second period. Parker angles right with a dribble, hands it off with a wing for Malou Savannah, left of the chamber screen. Pulls up at the foul line and knocks down a jump shot. Malou Savannah with a big basket. Before that, she had been just 5 of 19 shooting this year. It's down to a 1-point Lady Tiger lead.
Nice screen by Kennedy Large, and good job by Savannah rubbing off that screen to get open.
Ogle bounces it down low. They whip it in the left corner. Now they pull it back out. Real pump fakes, drives, feeds it down low to Allison. Wide open, and she blew the layup. Another missed layup for Allison, who picks it up off the floor, dribbles through traffic, throws it up and in, and she's fouled. Well, that's going to work about as well as it could possibly work for East Central. They blew a wide open layup. They got a 50-50 ball, and one of the second foul on Kennedy Large as the starting 5 now will return for the Bison.
Yeah, that was 4-on-1 against Kennedy Allison after she blew that bunny. But give it up to Kennedy Allison. She got on the floor, got after, kept fighting for the ball, and came away with it.
You're right, Scott. You'd see a lot of young players, and she is just a freshman from Mustang, just give up on the play altogether out of frustration. Foul shot is up, and it's good. East Central has hit 4 of their first 5 for the line, and they now lead it by 4. It's their biggest cushion of the afternoon, 19-15, as we play 2:10 here of period number 2. East Central is not a team you want to get into a foul shooting contest with. They're among the league's best at 82%. Peyton Taylor with it above her head, right wing side. With a left-handed dribble, gets to the foul line, lost the handle. Taken away by Madison Real. 1-on-1, now 2-on-1. Bounces it across the paint. The layup is blown by Izzy Cummings. East Central with a rebound as OBU gets back. Dribbling right, Crusoe, and she knocks down an elbow right jumper. McKenzie now with 8 in her buckets. 6 in a row really helped spur East Central from an early hole. It's at the other end, Izzy Cummings was riding Jalen Stapleton. It's called for the foul.
Well, McKenzie Crusoe out of Choctaw has an inside-outside game. She can put it on the floor, get to the rim, and she can hit the 3-pointer, too. That time she faked the 3, dribbled in for the 16-footer.
Petrarita seals down low. Ford finds her, and Andrea rolls the shot home. Incidentally, that foul, the 2nd against Izzy Cummings. 21-17 East Central. Under 7 minutes now to play here with the first half from Shawnee. Into the front court, Izzy Cummings dances with a basketball to Kennedy Cummings. She bricks a 3. Wasn't even close. Real hustles and saves it inbounds to Caruso. Real drives baseline, got by with a push and lays it in.
Well, at least Stapleton made Real go the right side down the right baseline that time.
You know what? That was an offensive foul that wasn't called, but the defensive rebound wasn't secured to even give her a second chance. 23-17 East Central. Ford, 2 dribbles, angles right. Now to Stapleton in the corner. Bison trail by their biggest deficit of the first half. Petrarita inside the arc out front. misses short. Rebound to Kennedy Large, who has played well off of the bench, averaging almost 4 points a game. Large already, or Cummings already has 1 point, and Crusoe knocks down another three. Crusoe with double figures with 11, and OBU's in trouble. They're down nine with 6:05 to play in the first half.
That's what I was talking about, that inside-outside game. That was a long three, too. Petrarita's 6 foot came out to try to cover that shot.
Peyton Taylor thought about a three, pump fakes, loses the handle, picks the baseline, bounces it to the cutter, 40, lays it in. Almost a turnover, instead it's the 9 point for Khalifa, and OBU gets closer. They trail now by seven.
Nice pass and nice cut by Ford, and Ford uses her body to keep the defense toward the goal to catch that pass.
Ogle tried to feed it down low, and it is off of OBU, out of bounds. The officials are Alan Richardson, Wes Cyrus, and Steve. The stat sheet didn't have his full name on there. Now they get together, they change it, and it's going to be OBU basketball. Bison trail by seven. They trail by as many as nine here in the first half. They've led by as many as six. Jalen Stapleton, elbow left to Petrarita. Whips it across the floor to Mallory Lockhart. Lobs it down low to Ford, who tips it out to Taylor, right corner, and she throws it away. OBU sloppy with the basketball. Ogle, another steal, bounces it to Real to the goal, misses the left-handed layup, but she's fouled.
Well, part of that on that fumble down there, Petrarita's got to be a little bit better receiver. She seemed a little bit lethargic and didn't come after the basketball very strong at all.
Lockhart with her first foul, team's third here of the period. First foul shot by Madison Real is good. If you're looking for help from Madison to the line, you're not going to get it. She's the 10th best all-time foul shooter in East Central history at right under 80% for her career. She hits both. She's in double figures with 10. Lead back to 9 with 5:12 to play in the half.
She was a nice guard for Totsi Manning at Deer Creek High School, too, in state tournament play.
Stapleton telegraphs the pass and around Petrarita. Ogle tips it out of bounds. Bison will inbound with 20 of the 30-second shot clock. 5:05 to play in the first half, 28-19 East Central. Taylor gets the inbounds pass from Lockhart. Out of Stapleton, Jalen to Ford, spins, attacks right, draws a triple team, goes up, missed it short, kept the rebound alive, but it's rebounded by Gabby Cummings. Boy, that's a great job on Khalifa Ford.
Yeah, you got a double and triple teamer, and that's what it took.
Down the paint goes Crusoe, scoops it high off the glass and missed it. Ogle tipped it out. Jalen has it, does not have the numbers, feeds it up ahead to Petrarita, who's hammered on the way to the goal. Yeah. And OBU has a chance to win on what was a 2-on-3 break.
That was outstanding play by Jalen Stapleton running that break. She could have thrown that ball earlier to Andrea Petrarita. She waited till the defense actually turned their back, and Petrarita had an open shot going to the goal.
Kennedy Cummings with the hack. It's her second time out of the floor. Petrarita to the free throw line when we return. With 4:40 to play in the opening half, it's East Central 28, Oklahoma Baptist 19.
Estate planning is a crucial step in protecting your family's future. With an estate plan, you can decide how to distribute your assets, make healthcare decisions, and support ministries after you pass away. It involves some pretty big decisions, but with guidance from Water's Edge, you can plan for your children's future, give to kingdom causes, and get expert help along the way. Build a solid foundation for your family. Start your estate plan today. Visit watersedgeservices.org.
Petrarita will be at the foul line, trying to cut into a 9-point East Central lead. Thelaney cleanly swishes down the first. Steve Searles is our third official in this ballgame. 28-20 East Central. They have led since the late stages of the first period. Led by one at the end of one. Second one is good. And it's now a 7-point game. 28-21 ECU with the lead of the basketball. OBU unbeaten in three home court games this season. Madison Real, left quarter to Kennedy Allison, angles to the foul line, whips it across the floor to Ogle, puts up a three and got it. Kate Ogle knocks down ECU's third three of the game, and they have a 10-point lead, 31-21. East Central now shooting 11 of 25 here in the first half.
Now Ogle has five rebounds to go with that three-pointer as well.
Wing right with a basketball stapled to the Petra Rida, lobs it down low. Ford kicks it out. Jalen for three, no good. And Ogle has the rebound. To get Ford some space, we're going to have to make some of those jump shots.
There's no doubt about that. And a little bit more arc for Stapleton as you did earlier.
Driving baseline is Allison, her 15-footer, no good. Khalifa Ford, averaging almost 9 rebounds a game, gets that one. Now to Stapleton, who drives, cross-courts it. Lockhart's three is short. And Peyton Taylor battling underneath, and I think OBU's going to keep the basketball. Well, it looked like she was on the back. They're going to say it was last touched by a Lady Tiger.
Now, that's a good call. Peyton Taylor inside the right block. Mackenzie Crusoe was in the middle lane, came all the way across into Taylor, and tipped that ball out of bounds.
Lockhart handles the inbounds pass and bounces it out to Jalen to Mallory right quarter. Lockhart is off to an 0-for-2 shooting start. Came in second in the country with 33 three-pointers made. Stapleton right of a screen, angles right, 5 to shoot, and a foul. Real absolutely leveled Jalen Stapleton. And neck with 5 of the shot clock.
The listeners can hear that tumble on the hardwood. Kaboom-boom.
How was that?
It was hitting the wood hard.
Look, that Buckley's is getting to you. First foul against Madison Real. Shot clock resets. It's down to 17. Lockhart against Real. Gets a screen, moves left. Now they roll forward. She pump fakes, drives, goes into 2 defenders, and a foul. That's against Cruz, so that's her first. Right now, that might be OBU's best option, is to put her out on the wing and let her go one-on-one.
I think they call it an Ogle. Ogle come across in the middle, and Khalifa Ford put that head fake up, got up in the air, and just came down with both arms.
The first on Kate, first on Crusoe. Ford switches down the first throw. Bison missed their first two at the line. They've now made 5 straight. Khalifa in double figures with 10. She has 10 or more for the 8th time and 10 starts as a junior. Second is up and it's good. She has looked good for the foul line. Came in shooting less than 60%. Bison trail ECU 31-23.
Yeah, right now it's Khalifa Ford. We're nothing for the Bison.
You're right. Right side, Allison with the basketball. Cross courts it and an offensive foul call. Madison Real had called for an illegal screen and she's missing. The official saying, hey, they're pushing off. Madison has her second. For East Central, that'll be turnover number 8.
Madison Real doesn't like it, neither does Matt Cole. And here comes a substitution. Kennedy Cummings in for Real.
3:04 to play here for the first half, 31-23. Madison Real has 10, so a chance maybe for OBU to make some hay with the 1,000-point score for the Lady Tigers on the bench.
That's a big opportunity for the green and white right here.
Stapleton drives left, pulls up, shoots, missed it, short rebound, poked out. Allison has it, then almost threw it away. Cummings goes into the East Central bench and saves it back in to Gabby Cummings. 2:41 to play first half. East Central's lead is 8. It's been as many as 10. Allison cuts left. Petra Ryder cuts her out. She whips it across the floor. Gabby Cummings leaves it right side for Caruso. Through the top of the circle, it's Cummings to Allison. She drives and throws it up and in with contact.
You know, Kennedy Allison, she does not put the ball on the floor with the first dribble. She got away with a couple of walks so far. They whistle her once or twice.
33-23, Central back in front by 10. Peyton Taylor picks a dribble up. Ford flashes high, gets it back to Taylor. Peyton gets it to Petra Ryder, and they're going to call her for a travel. I think one official was going to call a foul. The official behind the play actually signaled a turnover, and he might have gotten a little bit of help from Matt Cole on the East Central bench.
Yeah, I think that's the correct call because Petrida went right, left. That's 4 steps.
10 turnovers for OBU already. They bounce it out high. Allison to Caruso, her 15-footer front rims. Lockhart with a rebound. OBU to Stapleton. Here come the Bison up the right front court. To Peyton Taylor. She's run off the arc. Pulls up to the foul line. Jump shot back rims. Caruso with a rebound. Bison are just ice cold. Now 8 of 25 shooting. Caruso angles left to the baseline. Now back to the wing. Good defense by Peyton Taylor. Cummings gets the cross-court pass. Right side for Ogle. Allison turns to the three, angles right, bounces it for Kate Ogle. Ogle through the free throw line, off balance, throws it up, missed it. Taylor kept the rebound alive. Cummings has it. She's tied up by Khalifa Ford, who had one hand of the ball. And East Central will keep it with 1:20 to play here in the first half.
What a play by Khalifa Ford. She's blocking out Caruso out here on the left angle left and goes all the way under the goal. Sees that rebound go downside.
Kennedy Cummings to inbound. East Central leads it by 10 with a basketball. Wing right, Caruso drives and a blocking foul against Peyton Taylor. That's her first. It's also the fourth against Oklahoma Baptist, so East Central, who was into the double bonus in the first period, is closing in on the same thing here in the second with 1:14 to play before halftime. Cummings underneath the East Central to throw the black and orange clad Tigers. Leaves it right corner for Kennedy Allison. Top of the circle to Gabby Cummins. Cummins right side to Allison. They play off of her. Now it's Cummings for the basketball. Left side to Ogle and she travels.
How about you kept the right pivot foot now?
There's been some things in this game both ways. I don't know what
they're doing. Yeah, exactly.
1:03 to play in the first half. 33-23. Bison approaching their lowest scoring first half of the year. They have made just 8 of 25. East Central shooting 41% here on the road. Taylor drives baseline left. Now to Lockhart. Open three. Got it. We can't give her that much space. Bison have been 1 of 8 from beyond the arc before Mallory Lockhart, who finally converts on one of her first three threes, cuts it down to 7.
And that's the big cannon for the Bison from downtown. Mallory Lockhart among tops in the nation on three-pointers. 34 made this season.
Allison around Taylor. Payton with good defense. Forced her into a short shot, and Payton with a rebound. To Stapleton, a difference of less than a full second of the shot and game clock. Jalen dribbles on the Bison logo between the circles out front. 15 seconds to play here in the first half. 33-26, OBU trails. Lockhart gets a bounce pass right side. Spins on the baseline, bounces it for Jalen. Left of the screen from Ford. Trying to kick it out and threw it away again. Caruso with the interception. Throws it up ahead, out of bounds. She didn't think there was quite as much time left as there was. OBU will have it for the final second and a half.
That's three times Stapleton's been going into the defense and leaving her feet. Let that defender out there on the left wing intercept that pass.
Jalen has not had her best half of basketball. 0-3 shooting, 4 turnovers, and no assists. Stapleton will handle the inbounds pass, and that will do it. Two periods in the books. East Central leads at Oklahoma Baptist 33-26. Our halftime show is coming up next. This is OBU Basketball on Classic Hits KGFF. Thank you.
Jordan Klinger at McIntyre Law. We have over 100 years of experience fighting for Oklahomans injured in automobile and semi-accidents. Distracted driving is an epidemic. According to government studies, 1 in 4 crashes now involve texting and driving. That's 1.6 million accidents caused each year by distracted drivers. If you have been injured and you want to know your rights, call us now. The consultation is free. We love what we do and we're good at it. We are trial lawyers. Call McIntyre Law today.
You'll see why we've been voted best burger, best breakfast, and best waitress. Pine Cliff Printers is proud of its partnership with OBU. For your print needs, visit Pine Cliff Printers, 1815 North Harrison Street, right here in Shawnee. Busy students can keep up with their finances day or night using Tinker Federal Credit Union's convenient online services and mobile app. Visit them online at tinkersu.org for more information. Hey, Bison fans, you can update your green and gold wardrobe with the latest OBU apparel. Visit shopobubison.com, the online store of OBU Athletics. Shop OBU.
He's the lead singer for ACDC, Brian Johnson.
Yeah. I'd rather listen to him sing than that.
I'm not an
Does anybody ever come up and ask for
you look way too good to be the lead singer of the rock band, Brian. Way too good.
Welcome back to Bison Hill at halftime. East Central women 33, Oklahoma Baptist 26. OBU has 11 turnovers to East Central's 9. East Central has out-rebounded the Bison 20-17, led by Kate Ogle's 6 rebounds. Kate Ogle is 1 of 4 from the field, 1 for 2 from downtown with the 6 boards, 3 points. She's a junior college transfer from Baldwin City, Kansas, helping East Central in the paint. Madison Real, very good off the left hand. She's 4 of 5 from the field. 2 or 3 of those just on the drive to the glass. 2 for 2 from the free throw line. She has 10 points and 2 steals. Ogle also has 3 steals. Izzy Cummings is 1 for 3 from the field, 1 for 2 from downtown for 3 points. Mackenzie Caruso, 3 of 8 from the floor, 1 for 3 from beyond the arc, 2 for 2 from the free throw line, 9 points. Alexis Lyons, 1 for 3 from the floor. Mr. Only, 3-point attempt. She has a deuce. Kennedy Allison, 2 of 7 from the field, 1 for 1 from the free throw line for 5 points. Kennedy Cummings has 1 point. Missed her only 3-point attempt, 1 of 2 from the charity stripe. To round out the 33 points for East Central, for Oklahoma Baptist, Andrea Pecherida, 3 of 8 from the floor, 2 for 2 from the line, 8 points. Khalifa Ford hot again after that double-double last week, Saturday, in the win over Southeastern. Khalifa Ford was 9 of 12 from the field, 24 points, 11 rebounds. Today, in the first half, she's 4 of 6 from the floor. Started that with a 3-pointer, 1 for 1, 2 for 2 from the free throw line, 11 points, 3 rebounds, 2 assists. Mallory Lockhart, 1 of 3. Those were all trays. She has 3 points, 4 rebounds. Jalen Stapleton has not scored, 0 for 3 from the field. Missed both 3-point attempts. She does have 3 rebounds. Peyton Taylor, 0 for 1 from the field, 2 for 2 from the line. She has 2 points. And then rounding out the scoring for the Bison, Malou Savannah with a nice dribble left around the top of the key behind Kennedy Large's pick. Pull-up jumper from 17 feet. That was her point. She's 1 for 2 from the field for 2 points for OBU's 26 points. At halftime, East Central 33, Oklahoma Baptist 26. This is Bison basketball on KGFF Classic Hits. Thank you. Welcome back to Oklahoma Baptist University. East Central on top, 33-26 at intermission. East Central took the opening period by a 14-13 count and the second stanza by a 19-13 count for the 33-26 Tiger lead here at halftime. Biggest lead of the game for the Tigers was 10. at the 4:26 mark in the second period. OBU led by as many as six early when they were hot, with 4:14 to go in the first period. The best scoring run for East Central was nine. That came at the 9:12 mark before halftime. Oklahoma Baptist was five at the just under 8 minutes in the first quarter. Lead has changed once. The game's been tied once. East Central holds a 10-minute, 31-second advantage with the lead to 7 minutes, 4 seconds to the Bison. Points from turnovers, East Central 8, OBU 5. Points in the paint, Tigers 16, Bison 10. Second chance points, Tigers 7, Bison 2. Fast break points, East Central 6, Oklahoma Baptist 2. And then East Central triples the bench points again, 6-2 over OBU. Shooting by period for the Tigers, 5 of 15 for 33%, 1 of 5 from downtown, 3 for 4 from the line. In the second period, East Central shot 7 of 16 from the floor, 44%, 2 of 4 from downtown, 3 for 3 from the charity stripe. And for the game, the Tigers are now 12 of 31, 38.7%, 3 for 9 from beyond the arc, 6 of 7 from the free throw line at 86%. For Oklahoma Baptist, in the opening stands, a 5 of 14 from the floor, 35.7%, just 1 of 5 from downtown for 20%, 2 of 4 from the line. In the second period, Oklahoma Baptist, 4 of 12 from the floor, 1 for 4 from downtown, perfect 4 for 4 from the charity stripe in the second period. For the game, OBU is 9 of 26, 34.6%, 2 of 9 from beyond the arc, 22%. And 6 for 8 from the free throw line at 75%. Oklahoma Baptist has a pair of steals, one from Kendall Parker, one from Andrea Petrarita. East Central has 7, 3 by Kate Ogle, the transfer from Baldwin City, Kansas, Junior College, and Madison Real has a pair along with Mackenzie Crusoe and Alexis Lyons with one each. At halftime, East Central Tigers women 33, Oklahoma Baptist University Bison 26. This is Bison Basketball on KGFF Classic Hits. Okay.
Tom Miller, Scott Wattish, Bob Easley back here with you courtside at the Noble Complex halfway through game one of our twin bill to close out the home portion of 2021. ECU leads OBU 33-26. Get 11 points from Mackenzie Crusoe and 10 from Madison Rio, the leading scorers for Matt Cole's club. At halftime, Khalifa Ford, the only double-figure scorer for OBU. She has 11. In fact, the inside presence has really been pretty effective for OBU. Khalifa and Andrea have combined for 19 of the team's 26 points. Mitch, and this is the final home game of the calendar year 2021. OBU will next be in action on December the 30th in Arkadelphia. That'll be a 5:30 and 7:30 game against Henderson State. And then New Year's Day, we'll ring in the new year, hopefully with a couple of victories across the street at Ouachita Baptist, 1-3 on New Year's Day. Next home games will be on January 6th and January the 8th, Thursday night against Harding and Saturday afternoon against Arkansas Tech. Bison Basketball brought to you by the First National Bank and Trust Company for every season. We are your bank for life. Also by SSM Health, St. Anthony Hospital Shawnee, where they compassionately serve the healthcare needs of Shawnee, Oklahoma and surrounding communities. We're known for providing exceptional care and offering the latest advances in medical services. Bison Basketball also brought to you by the OBU app. The best way to follow your favorite Bison teams is with the all-new OBU mobile app. Download for free on your Apple or Android device by searching OBU Bison in the App Store or Google Play. 33-26 East Central at the break. The second half is coming up next from Shawnee. This is Oklahoma Baptist Bison Basketball on KGFF.
Okay.
Bison had the first possession to start the second half. They look for a backdoor cutting Khalifa Ford. It's knocked away from her. She'll whip it across the floor. Stapleton's three is off the side of the rim. OBU is now 2-for-10 from three-point range. They came in among the league's best at over 41%. 33-26 East Central early second half. And a baseline jumper by Caruso is nothing but net at the other end. Mackenzie Caruso with 13 points, making her 27th career start for the Black and Orange. 35-26, 9:22 to play here in the third. Peyton Taylor against the zone. Back to Jalen, to Peyton. Taylor's run off the arc, now attacks, leans for the left block. Shot's blocked out of bounds by Kennedy Allison. That's her first block of the season.
Good job by Allison to catch up with Peyton Taylor. Had a free run outside the left angle and a good block.
Taylor bounces it inbounds for Mallory Lockhart. She is just 1-of-3 shooting tonight from long distance. Peyton with it, slot right. Taylor left of the screen from Ford, comes to a jump stop, one to shoot. Stapleton fires a three and rolls off wing left. Ford battling on top of Khalifa out of bounds.
Well, Ford against two players trying to block her out, still almost came away with that ball before it slipped out of on the baseline.
Bison are now 1-for-their-last-9 from three, 1-for-their-last-8 from the floor. Now they have gone scoreless now for exactly the last 2 minutes, dating back to the end of the first half. 35-26, East Central moving from left to right into the offensive front court. Wing right, Madison Real skips the top of the circle. Izzy Cummings, left wing. Bad shot by Allison, misses everything. And the fourth rebound gathered up by Khalifa Ford. She's flirting with another double-double today. Ford to Peyton Taylor to Jalen Stapleton to the Bison Loco. Back right side, it's Khalifa Ford. She'll angle to the free throw line. That leaves it for Peyton Taylor, right wing. Shot clock already down to 10. Peyton with it, gets Crusoe with the run. A pump fake, drives back door, throws it up off the window, missed it. To right, a tip rebound. Real runs it down. Madison Real bangs her way into Stapleton and throws it up. Yeah.
Play by Stapleton, might have been able to take a charge. She fell back, might have went to her, but there it is again, Todd. Real going the left side of her. She's hard to stop.
11-point lead for East Central, the biggest of the contest as Ford attacks, a foul against Ogle, and that is her second. I'd like to know, I wish they would have kept this stat today, of all the fouls that have been called against East Central, and that now is their 10th of the ball game. I wonder how many of those have come against Khalifa Ford.
Well, Khalifa Ford forces you to cover her.
Ford around a double team, throws it up and in. Khalifa with 13, OBU cuts it down tonight again.
Split the double team and off the glass.
Crusoe loses the handle with the foul line, picks it up, kicks it out to Ogle, or three rattles off. Petra Ryder tips the rebound, and it was out of bounds, and they say it was last touched by East Central. It was at the opposite end. The only thing I could see is that maybe Izzy Cummings stepped to the baseline in pursuit of that ball.
I think Allison tipped that last. Petra Ryder did a good job pushing Allison underneath the rim.
37-28, OBU trailed a moment ago by 11. Lockhart being blanketed by Real, turns the corner and it's stripped out of her hands, gets it back, soft pass deflected, and the Tigers have another turnover. Ogle then nearly lost it into the front court. Bison now have turned it over 12 times in the contest. 37-28, ECU with 7:10 to play in the third. Crusoe will trigger a three. No, it's short for the left circle. Ford slides down for her fifth board. To Stapleton, Jalen to Khalifa out front, left side to Lockhart. Down low to Petra Ryder. Steps through two defenders, is triple teamed by a third. And somehow she's going to get the whistle and she'll go to the line. The third defender in this case, Izzy Cummings, was slow to get over there and picks up her third.
Nice move by Petra Ryder on the left side of the semicircle. She catches the pass and then, like you said, between the defenders, she spin pivots off her left foot toward the rim and gets the foul.
East Central wrestled control of this game from OBU, outscoring the Bison 19-13 to the second period. The second period in total points this year has been easily East Central's best. Before tonight, in their first seven games, they were plus 38. They cool off, though, in the second half in terms of points per quarter. See if OBU can take advantage, coming back from once down 11. Petra Ryder with a little body English rolls that one across the front of the rim and down. Andrea looking for a 10th point if she converts here. This would cut it down to 7. That's what it was at halftime. Foul shot is up, and that one spins off. Only the third miss for OBU tonight for the line. In fact, the Bison had made 7 straight before that miss from Petra Ryder. 37-29. Right side, Alexis Allen. Top of the circle is Cummings. They reverse it down low. Caruso pump fakes, gets around Taylor, goes back and lays it. She's having a game, isn't she?
Yeah, and Taylor's laying off, so if Caruso wants the outside shot, she has it. I don't know if the knee brace is keeping her slower or what, but Caruso went right by Taylor that time.
Lockhart throws it away out of bounds. Petra Ryder, though, made very little attempt to go get the basketball. And this is a very, very lethargic OBU effort right now.
Well, you could explain any better. At least from the beginning, Oklahoma Baptist had the lead early, up by 6 points.
Alexis Lyons, jump shot, pinballs in and out, left baseline. Taylor with the rebound to Jalen up the right side of the counterattack. East Central gets back. Lead is 10 for ECU with 6:12 to play here in the third period. Stapleton spins to the free throw line, leaves it for Ford, and now the three front rims. Nobody down to rebound. Petra Ryder didn't even challenge, and Crusoe has it uncontested.
Yeah, when Petra Ryder, being 6-footer, sees that shot goes up, she's got to crash. You're right, she did not go to the boards.
Kate Ogle, foul on extended left wing, cross courts it for Alexis Lyons. She spins it against Andrea, lobs it out front for Rio, who goes through two defenders and missed the left-handed layup. There you go, attack it again for the left. This time OBU was ready for it. Lyons, Cummings then steals a pass in the backcourt, misses the layup. Stapleton with a rebound that is tied up, and that's a turnover because the arrow favors East Central.
Boy, you got to give it up. to Kennedy Cummings. Good job by her just reading the eyes. Lethargic, as you pointed out before. A long bounce pass underneath your the defense's goal.
Lethargic, a.k.a. it looks like we've already gone home for the break. Lethargic, 39-29. 5:38 to play here in the first half. Bison are 1 of 6 from the floor in the third period. East Central is 3 of 9. The lob, they get it to Real. There's contact. She ran over Stapleton. No so either way. Madison is really incredulous with the officiating tonight. Bison have the window. Ford top of the circle to Peyton Taylor. That of Jalen Stapleton. 17 to shoot. Somebody attack. Taylor will put up a 3 left wing. It's an air ball. Khalifa Ford tips the rebound inbounds, but to Kate Ogle. Everybody's just standing around. It's a stacked offense. Caruso spins, foul line right, kicks into the right corner. 3 is short by Ogle. Taylor boxes out for the rebound, lost it, but Petraria has it for the Bison.
I think Ford tipped that shot to make it real short.
And a foul into the front court that's going to go against Mackenzie Caruso as she was riding Peyton Taylor into the front court. That's the first Caruso. Team's third of the period. We get a timeout. 4:58 to play, third period in Shawnee, Central League 29-29. This is Bison Basketball on KGFF. Okay.
Ever wonder where the capital A in Chick-fil-A came from? It started with grade A, top quality chicken. But we believed everything, not just the food, should be grade A.
A is for above and beyond.
An extra level of care.
A game.
From caring for our guests and our community to cleanliness and safe service with a My Pleasure. A is for all the little things we do to bring you our best every day.
A little funky dance.
And that too.
Jill Leslie, Kendall Parker, and Malou Savannah, who will throw it inside in. Out there for OBU out of the timeout, Khalifa Ford and Mallory Lockhart, the holdovers from the previous lineup. Savannah dribbles the ball off of her foot. Another OBU turnover. Madison Real with it. Down the floor, loves it up ahead, and it's tipped away by Lockhart. Pass intended for Cummings out of bounds.
Lockhart might have saved a bucket right there, but just she has that great hand-eye coordination. She gets a lot of defensive touches, and you don't realize how many blocked shots she gets.
Alexis Allen at a cross-court pass, open from 17, misses back rim. Kendall Parker with a rebound with her head up, brings it to the front court. Cross courts it for Lockhart for 3. That one is too strong. Leslie with a rebound, tipped it to herself. Good job by Jill. Back to Mallory. That one is off back rim. Ford an offensive rebound, dribbles out from underneath and resets wing right. 4:17 to play in the third. OBU showing a little bit of spark with this lineup out of the break.
Yeah, great job by Leslie. And then, of course, Ford always hungry for the basketball.
Ford waits for the triple team. Had it knocked out of her hands. Cross courts at Parker for 3. No good. And Real has it for East Central. 4 tries. That trip down the floor. And OBU couldn't get a bucket. Left side. Wing left. Cummings for 3. Misses short. Parker the rebound. Kendall brings it back the other way. 1-on-3 and an offensive foul. She pushed off. There was a little bit of an acting job by Madison Real, but there's no question that Kendall instigated the contact.
When that arm is extended, the official's going to call an offensive foul.
Bison with her 17th turnover of the contest. They have forced 9. On the year, OBU is minus 1.8 in turnover deficit, averaging almost 17 turnovers a ball game and forcing just over 14. 39-29 East Central. Lions bounces it for Caruso in the left low post, goes around Savannah, who grabs her and prevents a basket. Layup was good, but not before the third foul against Malou Savannah.
Yeah, Caruso has been taking Peyton Taylor off the dribble, and that time Malou Savannah was totally lost with the ball fake, then the baseline had to grab her.
Second foul of the period against OBU. They inbound a Real, muscles up and in off the glass through two defenders. Madison Real with her 6th basket, 14 points. Lead is 12, and that is the biggest of the night for ECU. Malou Savannah, left of a screen from Leslie, picks a dribble up, got by with steps, and then throws it away. Real with the errant pass, one-on-one against Lockhart, who strips the ball on the way up, and it's out of bounds, and it's off of Madison Real. How about the hustle that time by Lockhart?
That's two layups that Lockhart has interrupted and saved in transition the last two trips up the floor.
Good hustle by Lockhart, who's enduring one of her worst shooting games as a Bison, 1-for-5 tonight, all from three-point range. Savannah, left of a screen, picks it up and took a step before she did. Malou Savannah now has turned it over three of the last four times out of the floor.
Yeah, and that last one was just a soft pass across. You got to have mustard on these passes at this level. You can't just throw little soft arcing passes.
3:05 to play in the period. Real lobs it for Alexis Lyons against Jill Leslie. Off balance, throws it up and in for the right elbow to strike. And a foul underneath after the shot. They're calling Mallory Lockhart, so that's going to give East Central the basketball. And that's the second on Mallory Lockhart. 43-29 East Central. Oh, they are rolling today here at the Noble Complex. Lady Tigers will inbound. That's also the third team foul against OBU of the period with 2:51 to play. Left side, Alexis Lyons. They get it down, let it reel. Throws it up left-handed, missed it. Everybody standing around. Caruso dribbles out with the rebound. Now to Ogle through the top of the circle. Reel left side. Lyons, top of the key. Ogle, and she airballs that one.
Yeah, and the rebound before hit right at Malou Savannah's feet inside the right block, and she didn't grab it. Went out East Central, got an extra shot at the goal.
Kate Ogle is now 1-for-7 shooting, 1-for-5 from three-point range. East Central usually shoots well from beyond the arc. Coming into this one, they were 37%. Just 3-of-15 of the Lady Tigers tonight from long distance. Parker trying to get the lid off the basket, does. Gets one right circle. Kimbo with her first points. And it's down to 11, 43-32. Bison have been 2-for-16 from long distance before that one.
Some of that practice paid off for Kendall Parker. We came down here Wednesday, saw her shooting in the gym alone.
Lyons spins a three off left quarter. Rebound to Lockhart, to Parker. With 2:06 to play here with the third, OBU can get it under double digits. Savannah, guarded by Caruso, moves left of the forward screen. Comes to a jump stop, hand to the nail. Now it's Lockhart right of a Leslie screen. The Ford who pump fakes, goes down the paint, throws up a runner at back rims. Leslie flat-footed, fighting for the rebound, and Lyons has it. They're going to call her for a travel.
That's a great call by the official. She's going to let Lyons, if she slides with the ball, is fine, but once she popped up on her knees, that's a walk.
29th turnover of the ball game. That's the 10th for East Central. And we still have 11:45 to play in this ball game as Madison Real will check out and Gabby Cummings, a redshirt sophomore from Elgin, checks in off Matt Cole's bench. Savannah will inbound, Lockhart left quarter. Now to Parker, holds it above her head, being guarded by Kennedy Cummings to Savannah. And she bricked a three for the right circle. Rebound to Kate Ogle, 1:34 to play here in the third. Caruso slides right, kicks it in the right quarter. Angling to the wing is Cummings. Now to the top of the circle, it's Lyons. Left side to Gabby Cummings. Her return pass knocked away. Ford battling. Wins the battle. Now puts it on the floor. Shoots it up ahead left wing. Lockhart gets her feet set for three. Airballed it. And Savannah will run down the rebound of the far corner. And then throws it away again, or nearly threw it away, as the lob pass was deflected out of bounds by Gabby Cummings.
You know, Mallory Lockhart, she always sets up for the three, but that time Ford was at half court. If she cuts to the basket, I think Lockhart had a layup.
Khalifa Ford will come out. Kennedy Large comes in with 70 seconds to play. Oklahoma Baptist in the third quarter trailing at home where they're 3-0 this year, 43-32. Kendall Parker handles the inbounds pass, dances on the Bison's head, right front court, moves left of the Leslie screen, now pivots, goes up and draws the foul. That was over three defenders, and Kennedy Cummings picks up her third, and that was a bailout whistle.
Well, part of it is Kendall Parker got so deep down by the semicircle, dribbling on the left side of the lane, left-handed, then spin-pivoted in with her body into an East Central defender.
Madison Real is back in. Kennedy Allison returns for Matt Cole's club. 1 minute to play in the third, 43-32. These two will see each other again the final game of the regular season at the Kerr Activity Center on February the 26th. Foul shot by Parker, back rims. She is 0-of-3 at the foul line. Bison from the free throw line are 7 of 10. They average almost 13.5 makes per ball game, and Large misses short of the second. 11-point deficit, under a minute to go with a 30. Central has it. Down low with it as Allison takes a dribble, goes up, and Joe Wesley blocks the shot. Kennedy Large the rebound to Parker, up ahead. Savannah down low to Leslie, ducks around the defender and lays it in.
Great block by Leslie and a great pass by Malou Savannah. If she holds that ball long, that window closes, but it's a quick, almost no-look pass to Leslie on the cut for the layup.
43-34, half a minute to go in the third period. Kennedy Allison works foul on extended left wing, guarded by Jill Leslie. Now Mackenzie Crusoe working against Savannah top of the circle. Lions back between the circles to Cummings, to Allison. Shot clock at 7 for East Central. Allison cross courts at Lions 3 with 2 to shoot. Is short. Parker with a rebound. Kendall will bring it to the front court. 5 seconds to play here with the third. She attacks right against Cummings. Scoops it up. The shot is short. Lions the rebound. Outlets to Rio. Rio looks up. Fires from half court. It's short. And that will do it for the period. OBU has cut it down to 9, 43-34 with a little flicker of hope in the closing minutes of that third period. Back for the fourth in just a moment. Bison Trail 43-34 on Classic Hits KGFF.
This Christmas, give the gift of OBU basketball for only 50.
Spending life wisely means taking small steps towards a life of love and impact. And we're here to inspire and empower you along the way. Spend life wisely. First United Bank.
East Central wins the third period 10-8, a period that the two teams combined for 8 of 36 field goal shooting. Rebounds, Bison plus 5, they are plus 2 of the offensive glass, 8-6. Stapleton, Petra Ryan, Large, Lockhart, and Peyton Taylor, the 5 to open up the fourth period for OBU. Need to keep that little flicker of hope going. Lockhart bounces it for Large at the foul line. Kennedy whips it left side. Stapleton through the paint to Peyton Taylor, right wing. Peyton holds it above her head. Now to Petra Ryan on the foul line. Two long steps going down the paint, forces it up, missed it. Large with a stick back up and in. She ripped it away to Kennedy Large from Kennedy Allison and then threw it high off the glass with her left hand and it came down clean as you please.
Boy, what a mammoth offensive rebound by Kennedy Large.
Foul shot by Large is back rim, so OBU's missed 3 golden opportunities their last 3 free throws. 43-37. That foul, incidentally, was against Mackenzie Crusoe. Driving baseline. Crusoe gets a pass back. Whips it across the floor right side. Rio had a poke out of her hands from behind. That is turnover number 13 for East Central.
I think that was Petrarida, and she picked herself up off the floor. Big play by Large, big play by Petrarida.
Lockhart dances with a basketball. Now stationary, dribbles out front, bounces at foul line left for Petrarida. Goes down the paint, out of control, and a foul. We're going to call a block on East Central. It's against Izzy Cummings, and that's her fourth. So Andrea Petrarida will be at the free throw line, a chance with 9:01 to play to cut this down to a 5-point game. After East Central's largest lead had been 14 at the 3-minute mark of the third period.
Good move by Petrarida, had her back to the basket just inside the free throw line, fakes outside, then hooks around the right side, goes up strong with her body.
Petrarida will free throw twice. First one is up, and that one is no good. That's 4 straight misses at the line, and it's a 7-point game with 9:01 to play.
And that Kennedy Large rebound was huge, that opening possession.
Second one is good. Petra Ryada has her 10th point, and only her second, both for the foul line of the final half. 43-37. The intensity defensively now has really started to turn up by OBU.
Yeah, this is the most active you've seen the Bison move on the floor at all.
Crusoe, though, on a good skip pass, nails it elbow right. Mackenzie Crusoe was the leader of the comeback for East Central after OBU had a six-point lead in the first period. 45-37, Stapleton clears into the front court, left side to Taylor. Payton drives, pivots. Large ends up on the floor, 5 second counts on. Taylor gets it to Lockhart, who knocks down an eight-footer on the baseline. Mallory with five, it's a six-point game.
East Central's been doing such a good job by keeping Lockhart off the three-point line. They lost her down on the baseline.
Allison is gonna be bumped and fouled by Petra Wright at the other end. It's Andrea's first. Bo Overton is saying exactly what I thought. She didn't even touch her.
And that's on Mallory Lockhart. Well, she's got four. That's huge.
So it wasn't on Petra Ryder. Crusoe drives, and they're going to call a hand check foul against OBU. And
that wasn't a touch either. That, you know, Stapleton reached toward the basketball, pulled her hand back, and there's no contact.
Kennedy Large just picked up her third personal foul. So now one of your best weapons offensively comes out of the ballgame because of a phantom call. That's the second team foul against OBU here in the period. Allison rips an inbounds pass away, pulls up from seven. It's softly hit off the front of the rim. Bound into the arms of Ford to Stapleton. Up ahead to Khalifa Ford, who is wide open, and she stumbles.
Petra Ryder.
Yeah, I'm sorry. Petra Ryder on her own feet.
Perfect pass. She's got to be ready.
20 turnovers now as Petra Ryder will check out. Jill Leslie will check in. 45-39, under 8 minutes to go from Shawnee. Crusoe into the front court. Right side, Madison Real against the zone. Lobs it back to Cummings. Cummings with Taylor jumping in her face to Real. Penetrates the zone, kicks it out. Ogle's three good. Kate Ogle has two baskets, both a three from three-point range. She had been 1 of 7 for the floor and 1 of 5 before that three-pointer. 48-39, the lead back to 9. Spinning in is Ford, goes up, and an offensive foul called against Khalifa Ford.
No way, because on the shot, Khalifa Ford got hit on the arms. That's when Kennedy Allison hit the floor.
It's still not going to save her for a chewing from Bo Overton, who's really upset. 22 turnovers for OBU. Khalifa with her second, team's third. 22 turnovers, and yet you have a chance with 7.5 minutes to play, down 9.
Yeah, but you're going to have to stop these turnovers and going to have to make layups, not fall down or drop the ball out of bounds. Oklahoma Baptist, just if they make a couple open shots, you're right, they got a chance.
48-39 East Central. Bison in a zone. Real into the front court. Right wing for Ogle. Pass deflected by Taylor. It's run down by Crusoe. Crusoe kicks it left side for Lyons, who got out of the travel. Back to Madison, drives, bounces for Crusoe, and Khalifa Ford at the last instant poked it out of her hands out of bounds.
Peyton Taylor there as well. Peyton Taylor with a steal earlier, and then that tip in the backcourt almost got another steal.
Oh, is really upset right now with the officiating. 10 to shoot, they cross court at Cummings. Top of the circle, Crusoe got by with a travel. They're going to call a foul against Stapleton. That's her second.
And that's the same official every time. Stapleton was standing there. Crusoe, she's stumbling. That was a travel.
Bo wants a timeout. 7-11 to play for the Noble Complex. East Central 48, Oklahoma Baptist 39. This is Bison Basketball on KGFF.
Who do we look to shape our world? It'll be people who know how to think with their heads and their hearts. People who understand that faith is not the enemy of education, but its partner. More than book smart, more than business smart, they are wise in their whole being.
We are future shapers.
Learn to live well and lead well in God's world. Be a future shaper at OBU.
Trade in for more and buy it for less. At Hudaberg Chevy in Midwest City, it's that simple. Get more money for your trade and buy new Chevys for less. And you'll get payments that fit any budget. HudabergGN.com.
You can count on Hudaberg, we'll give you more.
Trade it in for more, buy it for less. It's that easy. At Hudaberg Buick GMC in Midwest City, it's that simple. Get more money for your trade and buy new Buicks and GMCs for less. HudabergGN.com.
You can count on Hudaberg, we'll give you more.
Scott Wattish back here with you at the Noble Complex on the Oklahoma Baptist campus, 48-39 ECU. They have led since the late stages of period number one, where they took a 14-13 lead into the second. Tigers inbound out of the Bison timeout. Mackenzie Crusoe left front court. Ogle top of the circle. Right side, Madison Real. Now to Alexis Lyons, top of the key. Lyons with seven to shoot, cross courts it for Cummings. To Real, penetrates, pulls up, and banks in a runner from 11.
Real, once again, good with that left hand, just inside the left elbow on the left side of the lane, off the glass, one-handed running jumper.
50-39, Tigers stretch it back to double digits, Ford with it left wing, guarded by Crusoe. Goes to Taylor, top of the circle, down to Stapleton, to Leslie, foul line right. She over the head, cross courts it in the left corner for Ford with 10 to shoot, and Khalifa loses it off of her foot.
That's a good defense by Crusoe. She poked and hit that ball when Khalifa Ford's trying to take Crusoe one-on-one to the rim, poked it out, and then Khalifa Ford was forced to kick it with her heel.
6-17 for the finish, 50-39. Boy, this thing has been a turnover fest on both sides. Alexis Lyons with it, wing left. Ogle works top of the circle. Kate swings it right side. Crusoe pulls it away from Ford. Back to Real, left side to Ogle. Kate to Madison, 10 to shoot. Real to Ogle, left side, right of the baseline, Cummings, 7 to shoot. Cummings cross courts it for Crusoe. Takes a step left, fires a three. It's an air ball on the rebound out of bounds. Last touch by Alexis Lyons. That's good ball movement, though, by the Tigers.
It was, but a great defense to go to the last second. And you know what? I think that's East Central's ball because I think Khalifa Ford got a tip on that with that left hand.
Bison have really struggled. They have made just one of their last 10 field goals. Stapleton around a screen. Cross courts at Taylor. Back to Jalen, slot left. Jill Leslie sets the pick. Now they cross court it for Taylor, left-handed dribble to Leslie for three out front. She got it. Jill is 1-for-2 from three tonight. She's now 2-of-6 for the season. It's 50-42 with 5.5 to go.
That's some life, only down 8.
Lyons rips an entry pass away at the foul line to Cummings, left front court. Ogle swings it right side, Caruso to a cutter. That's Gabby Cummings. Now to Real for three up front, and she hit it.
Madison Real having a ball game. That time just way out there beyond the men's three-point shot on the top of the key.
53-42 East Central, 5:03 to play. Taylor to Leslie, top of the circle. Jill, the true freshman, leaves it in front of us for Jalen Stapleton. Back to Kennedy Large. This possession taking a lot of time. Taylor slides left, now moves right, pivots on the right of the paint. To Leslie with seven to shoot. Now to Jalen, right of a Leslie screen, fires from 15 and got it. Jalen with her first bucket of the night with just over 4.5 to play, and it's a 9-point game.
Yeah, that time Stapleton, instead of just trying to look like she's trying to aim it in there, just letting it go. Nice shot coming off the curl.
Ogle with it above her head, cross court, intercepted by Khalifa Ford. Ford with her head up, angles through the top of the key, and a blocking foul against Mackenzie Crusoe. It'll be her second personal foul. That'll be the fourth against East Central here in this period. 4:22 to play. We have our final media timeout of the contest. East Central 53, Oklahoma Baptist 44. This is Bison Basketball on KGFF.
They're a brand new promotional goods company, locally owned here in Shawnee. Custom t-shirts, promotional items, or design needs, contact Great Plains at greatplainsgraphics.com.
We can't walk in your shoes. More work right beside you. But we can be here for you. In money. In life. We get it. We're on this path together. You and TFCU. Tinker Federal Credit Union.
To play in the ball game, 53-44. I just saw a post on social media. I love it. Everybody celebrating graduation today. And by the way, congratulations to, I think, 105 students and athletes on Bison Hill that went through winter commencement. The post was, Some people graduate with honors. I'm just honored to graduate. Isn't that great?
Yeah, because you were thinking the same thing from Blackwell.
Well, there's no doubt. I think they got me out of town just because they didn't want to deal with me anymore. Leslie to Stapleton right wing, and they're going to call a foul. And that'll be the fifth against East Central. It's against Madison Real. That's her third. And if you're Matt Cole in a game of 9 points, the last thing that you want to do is allow Oklahoma Baptist to have free throws. I had that as their fifth on the board. They have them for the fourth, so OBU will inbound. Both teams with four fouls. Lockhart handles the entry pass, bounces it for Stapleton out front. To Peyton Taylor, right of a screen from Leslie. Now to Ford. Khalifa sets a screen. Stapleton moves left, picks up foul line right. Shot in and out. Spun around the circumference of the hoop, and Kate Ogle has the rebound. That miss had some weight in a three-possession game with under four to play.
Yeah, the Tigers in a man-to-man defense, too. That's usually Khalifa Ford time going one-on-one, but Stapleton had a good look there.
Right side, Izzy Cummings. She's been quiet tonight. Ogle with it, foul on left. Kicks it out to Cummings. Her three back rims. Khalifa Ford with a rebound. It's her eighth rebound to go along with 13 points. Ford tonight has played 27 minutes. Khalifa with it, and the Bison logo out front hands it off to Peyton Taylor. With 3:19 to play, OBU in desperation mode, trailing by nine. Bison trying to avoid a split of their first four conference games this year, keeping it 2-1. A game behind first place, Arkansas Tech, and Southwestern of the four that has it knocked off of her leg out of bounds.
That's again, Caruso got her hand in the cookie jar, tipped that ball off of Khalifa Ford. Two times, good job by Caruso.
17-6, East Central's advantage in points off turnovers. 53-44, winding towards 3 minutes to play in Shawnee. Head of the circle, Izzy Cummings. To Real, foul line right, Caruso kicks it out. Ogle's three right corner, no good. Ford high for the rebound. Gets it to Stapleton, Jalen through two defenders to the goal, and an offensive foul.
Yeah, I like that call because Stapleton drew all the contact on purpose with Real was falling backwards toward the baseline. All Stapleton had to do is pull up and lay it off the glass because Real was going to run out of bounds.
Madison Real has hit three of her last four. Her team is scoreless for the last 2 minutes. OBU's gone scoreless now for 2.5 minutes. That's their 24th turnover of the ball game. 53-44. Right, Madison Real with it. Top of the circle, Alexis Allen. Foul line left, Obel. Kate takes a dribble, whips it left. Crusoe's three good. That may have done it. Why should it not be Mackenzie Crusoe that may have put the final nail in OBU's coffin tonight? 56-44 with 2:17 to play.
Yeah, Caruso guarding Khalifa Ford, the toughest player out there to guard.
Ford had it knocked out of her hands by Caruso, head of the circle. Goes to Stapleton left wing, then to Leslie, a long three. Good! That was well behind the men's three-point line. Jill has hit two three-point baskets at OBU. Trails by nine with two to play.
Yeah, that's two huge threes by Leslie, 6'3" outside.
Ogle gets it to Lyons, who cuts back door, then Alexis throws it away. It's intercepted by Stapleton. 1:52 to play, OBU down 56-47. Khalifa Ford, top of the circle. Bo Overton off to her left, saying, go to work, go to work. Stapleton moves right of the forward screen. Leslie in the slot right with the basketball. With a Taylor wing, it's Taylor. Peyton attacks, throws up a runner and got it. Five straight for OBU. Peyton Taylor with her first field goal, her fourth point. 1:33 to play, and Matt Cole is livid with his team right now. It's a seven-point game, 56-49, as we keep it right here, Scott. And there's just been flashes today of what we've seen.
Yes. Whataburger's honey barbecue chicken strip sandwich. It's just so, you know, it's almost too hard to put into words. Good thing there's the honey barbecue chicken strip sandwich at Whataburger.
Up in the air a little bit, goes around, pulls up at the bottom of the dotted line for the bucket.
Bison basketball brought to you by the OBU Bison app, also by SSM Health, St. Anthony Hospital, Theopolis, and by McIntyre Law. Game two coming up, OBU's men. Apparently they're going to get an early holiday gift. Brantley Thompson expected to play tonight. He has missed the last five games since going down with an ankle injury in a non-conference road win at Washburn. Bison will pick the Tigers up out of the timeout full court. Caruso runs the baseline and bounces it down to Kennedy Cummings. She'll lob it to Ogle, and they beat the pressure. She touches it to Rio right side. Madison with the left hand is going to angle back between the circles. 1:23 to play. OBU down 56-49. Right side is Caruso. Both teams shooting 36%, but turnovers and points off those mistakes. A huge, huge statistic in favor of VCU. Bison in a zone defense, 6 to shoot. Ogle with it to Cummings, top of the circle, 4 to shoot. Now to Izzy Cummings, who missed everything on a runner that was well defended by Leslie. Stapleton on the rebound, pushes up ahead to Chambers, who bounces it for Ford, pushed off, got by with it, missed the bump. And Caruso is going to be called for the foul. That's her third.
Yeah, you could have went either way on that one, Todd. That Cleveland Ford just bullying her way in there, going for two. The 55.4 seconds left. Got to make these two free throws now. Matt Cole's going to try to run the clock down again.
Khalifa is 2 of 2 at the foul line tonight. Going back to the last two games, she is 6 of 7. Now make it 7 of 8. And that had gotten her free throw percentage up to very near 60% coming in. OBU has missed opportunities for the foul line today as well. With that make, they are 8 of 15. Second one is good. 56-51. Here comes the full court pressure. Caruso inbounds to Real, who took steps. And they're going to call a foul against OBU. That'll be their fifth. And they're calling it on Stapleton, who has her fourth. And now Madison Real, one of the all-time greats in program history for East Central for the line, will go there for a pair.
Stapleton was the back defender on that double team in the trap. I thought Stapleton had some space, was giving ground, and Real just was trying to force her way up.
Madison's first shot is up at front rims and front.
All then lock.
You know what? That's a big miss because it's still a two possession game if she hits this free throw with 52 coming up, the Tigers and the Bison. Second one is up, and that one is good. So Madison Real hits the free throw. Bo Overton wants a timeout. 57-51, ECU with 54 seconds to play. You know, last Saturday I asked Adam DeWitt, can I really take a picture of you? Is this the last time you're leaving this gym? And he laughed and said, it's the last time. Well, I'm thinking about doing the same thing with
makes a chicken sandwich spicy. Fiery sauces, crazy hot toppings. Nope, it's all in the marinade. The heat and the flavor must come from within. Good thing there's the new limited time spicy chicken sandwich at Whataburger.
With that left-handed dribble.
Yeah, she's played 33 minutes of the ball game. Those 2 assists, 4 steals, tops for East Central. OBU has 2 double figures, 4, 1 rebound away from a double-double, 15-9. Petra Ryder with 10 points, 3 rebounds. Lockhart just 2 of 7 shooting today, 1 of 6 from 3, 5.6 rebounds. OBU is a team 5 for 21 from 3, 36% for the ball game. They'll advance the ball out of the front court, out of the timeout. Peyton Taylor will trigger it in across the way from us. Better hurry, the 5 second count's on. And Jalen Stapleton just did get free to handle the pass. Stapleton being ridden by Caruso, and finally a foul is called. And that's the fourth of McKenzie. And that only occurred after Bo Overton hopped up off the bench and screamed foul.
Yeah, that was, you're right, about 2 seconds after the hit. Stapleton, good job being strong with the basketball with the left hand going in the lane.
Chambers will check back in. Stapleton will have 2 for the line to cut it to a 4-point game, and she back rims that one. Jalen Stapleton is really good at the foul line. Right at 80% for her 3 years on Bison Hill, 85% today. And she misses a very, very costly one. Second one is on the way, and that one is good. Jalen with her third point, 57-52, 49 seconds to play. Ogle gets the inbounds pass. Now they get it middle of the floor to Cummings, who beats the pressure. She'll come to a jump stop out front to Madison Real. Difference of 19 of the shot and game clock, and there's the foul. It's Madison Chambers' second, and it's going to occur against Kennedy Cummings, about 28 feet from the basket, and Cummings will shoot 2.
Second person, Taylor, number 25.
Taylor will come in for Chambers.
Kennedy Cummings at the line.
Cummings hits both. It's going to be really difficult with 38.4 seconds to play.
She's the only Tiger to miss all game.
She misses that one short.
Her and Madison Real, who missed the last one. Yeah.
Yep, Real had been 2 of 2, split her last 2. They have shot very well for the foul line. In Central, 7 of 10, came in at 83%. Second one is good. Well, OBU still has life. It's a two-possession game, but you better hurry. 35 seconds to play. Stapleton with the Bison down six into the paint. Gets it to Lesler, who lays it up and in. And Bo Overton immediately wants a timeout. 58-54 with 32 seconds to play. We'll keep it right here. And remind you that located in the heart of Shawnee's Depot District, Theopolis is a neighborhood restaurant offering an exciting menu of scratch-made dishes highlighting local ingredients. Their modern, eclectic downtown space includes ample outdoor seating and the best live music in the area on Theo's patio.
Attorney Jordan Klinger at McIntyre Law. We have over 100 years of experience fighting for Oklahomans injured in automobile and semi-accidents. Distracted driving is an epidemic. According to government studies, one in four crashes now involve texting and driving. That's 1.6 million accidents caused each year by distracted drivers. If you have been injured and you want to know your rights, call us now. The consultation is free. We love what we do and we're good at it. We are trial lawyers. Call McIntyre Law today.
He was going to take us to dinner anyway.
Stapleton, great job pushing that ball. Bad defense by East Central. Stapleton pushed that ball up so quick, and then Gil Leslie up here near the free throw line just kind of meanders toward the basket. Perfect pass, uncontested layup for Leslie.
OBU has hit seven of the last eight from the field to get up to 37%. The Bison also on a 10-2 run over the last 157, but will it be enough? OBU does not have any more timeouts. East Central has three remaining. 32.4 seconds to play. The Lady Tigers 58, OBU 54. East Central has won in Denton. They have won in San Antonio. And trying to win here in Shawnee tonight. They're 2-2 in four road games. OBU counts a 14-point home court victory over Northeastern State, a 21-point victory over Midwestern State. And last weekend, a 66-51 winner over Southeastern as their three home court wins. Bison last year won by 10 here at Shawnee, their first win in more than 3 years against East Central. They lost 10 straight to the Tigers before that win. Here we go. Madison Chambers will front the inbounds pass to Cummings to Real. Real goes around Stapleton to the goal, and she's fouled.
Well,
and that should be the fifth on Jalen. Guess my question is, you don't really want to foul Madison, but at this juncture, you don't have much choice. Why let her take 3 or 4 seconds off the clock and then foul her?
Yeah, the only thing I was worried about is if Madison Real made that and won, the game's over. But as long as that she's shooting, you know, Madison Real actually missed that last free throw. So
foul shot by Real is nothing but net. The good news is, even if she makes both, it's still a two-possession game, but no timeouts and only 28 seconds left. It is going to be very difficult. Real hits both. OBU down to their final match, and there's a stiff north wind blowing. Into the front court is Peyton Taylor. Pivots, goes to Lockhart, left side. 19 seconds to play. Mallory doing a lot of dribbling to four. Khalifa going to attack mode. Crusoe falls away. Khalifa's foul line, right jumper, no. Leslie with a rebound to Taylor. Goes up strong and is fouled with 8.9 seconds to play. Kate Ogle will pick up her third. It's just about academic at this point. OBU down six, but Jill Taylor can go to the free, or Peyton Taylor can go to the free throw line where she's 2 of 2.
Well, you talk about Mallory Lockhart dribbling around. That was set up for her to shoot the three, the big three-point gun for the Bison, but good defense by East Central all night long, keeping her out
Peyton,
off the line.
Who grew up in the shadows of East Central. She's from Ada, hits both free throws. And Matt Cole wants a 30-second timeout. The best way to follow your favorite Bison teams is with the all-new OBU mobile app. Download for free on your Apple or Android device by searching OBU Bison in the App Store or Google Play. Tell you what, I've been proud of the effort here in the fourth quarter because, as we mentioned in the third quarter, I thought they were really doing a lot of sleepwalking. In fact, even said it looked like they had headed home for the holidays, but Bo started the fourth period with a different lineup, and that kind of spurred the charge, and it's just going to be too little too late for OBU.
You know, about spurring that charge is freshman Jill Leslie, 6 foot
You're
three.
Right.
She hit that three-pointer early in the fourth quarter. She also hit that one here later in the period. So Leslie's a very good spot-up shooter and stretching that defense. That opened up some things for, you know, Peyton Taylor to get inside and Khalifa Ford. But good job by Matt Cole keeping Mallory Lockhart off the three-point line.
Jill Leslie with 10 points, second time in the last three games she's had double figures. Caruso fouled by Madison Chambers. And that's her third. And now Mackenzie Caruso, who hit the second of her two threes that really felt like the backbreaker, will go to the line more than likely to put this thing away with 7.5 seconds to play. Yeah, first foul shot is up, and it is good. Not the biggest crowd here, Scott, but for crying out loud, why does this place go quiet when the visitors are at the free throw line?
Well, I think they heard you say on the broadcast, this game's over.
Russo's second foul shot, no good. There's the double-double for Ford. Khalifa in transition, had it poked away from behind, and that will do it. 61-56, Matt Cole continues his mastery of Oklahoma Baptist. East Central has won 11 of the last 14 meetings from OBU in women's hoops. 61-56, our final. Our postgame show is coming up next on Classic Hits, KGFF.
Thanks for joining us this evening, your women's basketball team. Johnson Pickett Courting in the Noble Complex until January 2022.
Let me tell you a story. A story about a woman who walks miles to carry undrinkable water to her family. Let me tell you about the water. Water everywhere, but not a drop to drink after a hurricane. I'll tell you about people, millions of people, who find themselves in a strange land far, far away. And I'll tell you a story about a farmer whose family and finances are being starved by drought. And how, on the other side of the world, there is a family starving for nutrients in a food desert. I'll tell you the tale of a trafficked teenager waiting to be assaulted again tonight. And again. And again. And once upon a time, there was a child who would go to sleep without a bedtime story because that child didn't have someone to read them a bedtime story. It wasn't just once upon a time. It was hundreds of thousands and even millions upon a time. But that's not where the story has to end. Together, as Southern Baptists, we can rewrite the story. Together, we can become an unstoppable force of hope. Together, we can respond. Together, we can meet needs across the globe. Together, we can change lives in our own communities. Together, we are Send Relief.
Todd Miller, Scott Wunsch back here with you inside.